Yo, what's up? Hey guys, this is ChairGTables, and today I'm going to be showing you one of the greatest arcade games in the whole world. This is one of my personal favorite games to play, like, ever. And I'm gonna show you guys, like, okay, so a lot of people would say this is a very difficult game, but I'm gonna show you that if you just got the right mindset and you got the right equipment, you got this. Anyone can run this game, and I believe that you too can do this. So today I'm gonna show you how awesome Metal Slug is. So right now we're about to start. Okay. Alright, so I'm gonna give a countdown of 3, 2, 1. Oh, wait. Hold on. Just to let you know. The timer actually starts when Mark Rossi, the guy that we play as, touches the ground. So that's when the time actually starts. All right, so 3, 2, 1, let's go! All right, here we go. This is Metal Slug. So first thing we gotta do is we gotta get the heavy machine gun. There we go. So we got the heavy machine gun, but you know, we don't really gotta use it right now. Just save it for later. And here we go, this is the first big enemy, but you know, we just gotta get rid of him. So you might be wondering, why did I throw two grenades at the missiles? Or rather the bombs. The thing is, like, the hitbox for the bombs that you throw is actually much bigger. So the hitbox is actually, the explosion part of the hitbox is actually part of it. So you can throw it, and anything above it also gets hit. Also, you need 20 bombs right here, and the boss is already dead. That's it! That's the thing! You just need 20 bombs, and the boss can't even do anything at you. Oh, also, don't forget, you gotta make sure you're holding down the button so you can kind of move the text faster for that section. And with that, mission one is complete. We're moving on to mission two, and we got here in the city. Ooh. So you gotta make sure you fall down from the parachute. Boom, boom, and we throw a grenade down here so that when we touch the edge of the screen, we're moving. So that's one of the things about Metal Slug. You gotta kill all the enemies so you can move past. So don't get that flame shot just yet. Oops. So yeah, we didn't get it earlier because the firing rate of the flame shot is a bit slower. So we kind of have to depend on the handgun for the moment. All right, so we're gonna use the flame shot here and then throw all our grenades. And now we got the rocket launcher. And with that, we get to explode the boat. And make sure you jump right here, throw two missiles, and right there, it's just instantaneously goes down. And you might be wondering, why am I not shooting? You see, can't really damage the boat until it stops. I don't know why! It's just like that! It's the second boat! It makes no sense! Like, you see, this is the third boat, and we can shoot it and it gets damaged. Like, it's just the second boat. Makes no sense, but awesome. We got the best weapon in the game. It's a shotgun, so, you know, you'll see how strong this is, but, like, geez, look at this. Boom, boom, throw two grenades. And just like that, it's all cleared. So the grenade is, so you might be wondering why do I have to throw two grenades right there? So the thing is, that little tank right there, like, it plays a little animation if you kill it with bullets. But if you use a grenade, it just explodes right away. Okay, so make sure you don't get this grandpa right here because he gives you a heavy machine gun. So the game knows, like, how strong the shotgun is. And come on, scroll the screen. Sometimes it does that, it just doesn't want to scroll the screen even though you clear all the enemies. So, like, sometimes the game just like, okay, here's the heavy machine gun, but it's because they want to overwrite the shotgun because it's much stronger. Alright, so I throw a grenade here, and it's like, ugh! You see? That, we got it! We got the first strike! or first attack! Alright, so just as long as you're holding right over here, you can throw grenades at a much faster rate. Get this guy out of here. Alright. So, all he needs is just one shot. Okay, let me tell you something about the boss. So this boss, even if you kill it already, if it has only like 1 HP, it can't really die until General Morden. He's the final boss, by the way, until he shows up, because they have to show the animation where he gets blown off the ship and goes like, ah! Alright, so you might be wondering why I didn't get the grandpa right there, and the main reason for that is, well, I kind of just want to use my handgun right here and just jump around. If you have the heavy machine gun, you could actually aim it. It's one of the weapons in the game where you could actually kind of angle it. All right, so you see right here, this is the elevator. This is where we're gonna take our first intentional death. So when you die right here, it spawns you over there, and you don't have to wait for anyone. Okay, awesome. Now we're gonna move up to the mountain. All right, make sure this guy doesn't mess you up. Awesome. So the jumps here are a bit tight for casual players. And here we go. This is Alan, but I used to call him as my uncle when I was younger. So, oh no, that's not good. Okay, so this is not good right now. Okay, so what you want to do is you just want to stick next to him, and he's going to be stuck in... See you in the ass! Okay, so like he can't really do anything if you're sticking next to him, because he just wants to melee you, and he doesn't really shoot. It makes the fight much easier. Nice, we got it! Uh-oh! Oh! That was close. Okay. How many jump scares are we going to get here? Yeah, there. So we got one jump scare over there. It's random. All right, so I'm gonna throw two grenades right here, and then I'm gonna shoot him twice with a cannon. All right, right. I'm gonna throw some grenades so we can make quick work of these guys. There we go. Oh no! Not eliminated the guy on the left. My bad. Oh, by the way, this is just pretty straightforward, so we can get like a donation right over here.
Sounds perfect, Chair. We got some donations rolling in. We got Tia. But $20 saying, I wasn't expecting to see a familiar face. I remember Chair as an organizer for local FGC events. Little did I know, they also run my absolute favorite games. I really ought to learn the Metal Slug X run. Best of luck, Chair. Mash on Morden until mission all over. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Yes, I do organize a lot of fighting game tournaments. It's actually one of my biggest passions. And, you know, eventually, I also got Metal Slug in the... I mean, you know, we got Metal Slug in the arcade, so I definitely love to play that alongside fighting games. But yes, thank you so much for the donation. And with that, Mission 3 is complete. We're going to go over to Mission 4. And this one's a quick one because the camera barely locks. And, you know, in the previous chapter, so we kind of had a lot of moments where... Oops. My bad on that. So yeah, the third boss, you might be wondering, like, why did we need to take the tank? The tank is, like, a lot slower. But the thing is, like, in this game, if you have the slug with you, you actually could throw a lot more grenades than when you're just, you know, just a person. If you're just a person, you can only throw two grenades at a time. Okay, I'm gonna take it safe and not jump there. So sometimes they forget to make sure you don't get the heavy machine gun, SMH. So yeah, like I was telling you earlier, this game is aware like how strong the shotgun is, and just like that, this boss is already dead. I told you guys, like, the shotgun is so overpowered here. They give you the heavy machine gun there, so it'll make the boss fight actually feel difficult. But with the shotgun, like, they die, like, immediately. SMH. All right, so now we're on to another short chapter. Barely any screen locks again. Make sure you delay your third jump a little bit so he doesn't snipe you. All right, awesome. Okay. He kind of delayed his shot there, so that was my bad. So we got our first continue already. All right, so we go down here. Ooh, okay. I thought that was a grenade going down, and I want to make sure I don't get hit by that. It's all good. It's all good. Sorry, guys. No one CC today. Right? Get rid of this gate! Oh, that was close. Get rid of the tank. We don't need any slow-moving tanks right here. Watch out for the tactical driver! All right, here we go. And here we are. We're already at the boss. So throw all your grenades right here. And you just kind of have to wait. So you can tell that it's going to its next phase if it has like flat tires over here. Okay, so we'll use all of your grenades right here. Awesome. And with that, the boss is dead. Yeah, the boss is dead. Don't worry about it. You might be wondering, what am I doing? Why am I not shooting it? What's happening? So the thing is, like, this boss is, like, on the timer. And all he needs is just, like, one shot. It just needs time. So like, I literally put it at, like, 1 HP. And it just doesn't want to die until it has some time. So it's like, okay, we're at 1 HP. I don't want to die just yet. So it just needs some time. Alright, so we're now at the final mission. This is the hardest thing ever. Like, legit. Alright, so first, we got the bad RNG. Okay, so we need to make sure we stab all of these guys in one swoop. And with that, the game thinks like, oh, you kill all the enemies in the wave? Nice. So you don't have to, it doesn't have to spawn anymore. Okay. Whoa! Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa, 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 whoa. Whoa! Oh! Yeah, so this mission right here spawns too many enemies. Oh, okay, no! Okay, it's all good. Okay, so at least we got the shotgun spawn right here. Okay. Whoa! 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 Okay. But yeah, it's all good. That was my bad. This is honestly one of the hardest. I was really hoping that we would get the shotgun because that really makes quick work of this section right here. I wanted to make sure that I don't throw too many bombs because we need to save these grandpas right there. I call them grandpas because that's what I called them when I was a kid. You know, and like, you know, we don't really know what these guys are called, but yeah, so that's what I called them, and it just kind of stuck with me. All right, so what we need to do now is we need to get rid of these planes. So they're gonna come out of top. So we didn't get the good pattern. The good pattern is when they appear like directly on the right, not coming in from the corner over there. All right, here we go. All right, if we do good, we could clear them off all right here. And now the auto scroller begins. All right, so we have this helicopter right here, but if you throw a grenade, it kills the plane. And it's like, oh, you killed the plane. Let's kill the helicopter in one hit too. All right, so now we're in an auto scroller section, so we can go ahead and grab some donations in.
Sure thing, Chair. Keep that energy coming. We got Yaiko2111, the $15 donation. They say, I can't resist giving my donation during the Metal Slug run. Looking forward to this run all week. So ready for this action. Good luck to ChairGTables to keep those buttons glowing. All right, we got $15 from Vuxandra. They say, shoot today, friends tomorrow. Let's go, Chair. Don't let RNG stop your clock and yeet those grenades just like you yeet yourself into everyone's heart. Cute game. Aww.
Awesome. Think, Vox, I'll make you proud! Thank you for everything! Okay, we're now coming up on the last part of of Mission 6 right here. We just gotta make sure we survive. Okay, here we go. So clear him off, clear him off, clear him off. Okay, we have 50 grenades. This should be enough for the final boss. We're coming up on the final boss. Okay, so time happens when the final boss dies, and you'll know when he goes, ah! Okay, so here we go. He comes out of there. Oh no, this is not looking good right now. He's high up. Oh, he needs to come down a bit lower. Okay. So here comes the missiles. We just need to kind of misdirect them going up here. And with that, this boss can't really act until... Oh, okay, here comes the... Oh, that was close. Oh! Oh, come on! Yes! Here we go! Time! Time! Oh! All right. That was scary, okay, because like, so we had really great RNG there, because like, the final boss could sometimes go on the top corner and you can't really reach him, and he does like this missile attack, and we can't really do anything about that, but this one we got really great RNG, so, oh, that was good, that was a good run, jeez. Oh man, guys. This was an amazing run. There was a few mistakes along the way, but hey, like it did went through smoothly. We got a bit of bad RNG, but hey, at least the final boss was great RNG. And with that, this is Metal Slug. Iggyzig. What would you say would be the time that you got?
GDQ time is 12 minutes, 40 seconds.
Oh!
Yes.
Wait. I think that's PV for my
no
for my, no. Let me see. It is. It's PV. It's PV. I got PV.
Yes.
It's our world record, but I got PB. Let's go! I did it! Yatta! Yatta! Oh man. Guys, thank you so much. Shout outs for everyone speedrunning Metal Slug. I've learned a lot, so much from you guys. And shout outs to Frost Walrus from Mega Man X4. I hope you guys have a great time. GDQ has been hype. There's a lot of great runs coming up to you guys. So I hope you guys have fun. And if you guys are interested in Metal Slug, there's always the Metal Slug Discord. You can find it on this Metal Slug speedrun leaderboard. And we'll be seeing you there. Thank you very much.
Chair, a PB. That run was amazing. Thank you so much for Metal Slug. Thank you so much for the energy. Y'all need some coffee in the morning. Nah, you need ChairGTables in the morning. Go ahead and drop them a follow. That was incredible. Just two quick donations. We got $5 from Tech Newman saying, I'm loving this run, loving this energy, loving how you're destroying Metal Slug. Hype! Yeah, I'm feeling the same way. Thank you very much. And we have Powder Milkman with a $10 donation. I think they want me to do some sort of chair imitation here. Says here, Metal Slug. Ah! Oh, man. That was incredible, Chair, again. And thank you for that PB. GDQ magic happening again. All right, we're going to be heading to a galaxy far, far away in just a short time from now. After this little break, perfect time to grab a tasty treat, like some tangerine slices maybe, or, ooh, tabbouleh. Oh, they'd be so refreshing and crunchy right now. Tabbouleh is so good. But hey, don't let your snack dreams be dreams, though. Get you something and come back soon, because AGDQ 2023 Online will be returning after these messages. Welcome back, everyone, to Awesome Games Done Quick 2023 Online. What we got up for you next is a fine game, the expansion to one of my all-time favorite classic titles, Dark Forces 2, Jedi Knight, Mysteries of the Sith. Alnak, a resident Jedi Master, is going to be doing an 80% run of the game, doing some force-powered tricks for all of you pretty much right off the bat. It's a great one, great time. We're going to have it up for you in just a little bit. Until then, got a $20 donation from Oligan Chomik, saying, can't wait for the Skyward Sword run later today. Blindfolded Demise fight? That sounds interesting. Indeed, and let's check where we are. Wow, $4,355 out of the $15,000 needed. Y'all are doing amazing getting those going on, and we are upon the precipice of $900,000. Everybody, keep it going. Y'all are doing great so far. And now, I'd like to take a brief second to tell y'all about GDQ Hotfix. Speedrunning isn't just limited to AGDQ and SGDQ. You can watch every day, every weekday night at 7 p.m. Eastern and weekends at 1 p.m. Eastern here on Games Done Quick with Hotfix. We have 22 different shows with specials on the weekends. For more information, go to gamesdonequick.com/hotfix. Hotfix shows off communities in speedrunning that are sometimes overlooked during marathons and elevates speedrunners year-round. We have shows for all interests, including ones that can help you find new games, teach you how to speedrun, and shows focused on more niche parts of speedrunning, such as randomizers. And we also have special events, such as Unapologetically Black and Fast. UBAF is back, running its second marathon this February 11th to the 12th, showcasing all levels of speedrunning, challenge running, and showcase prowess from black speedrunners in the community. Such an awesome weekend for last year's UBAF. I am looking forward to next month. Join us for this returning Black History speedrunning celebration on Hotfix. All right, we got ourselves a limerick from an Onyx Mouse for a $50 donation. They say, you think gymnast needs both his eyes in order to take down Tamize. But for enough gold, he'll put on blindfold and astound us with skills supersized. All right, phenomenal limerick. Thank you kindly. All the GDQ poetry coming in. You know you'll love to see it. You know you'll love to hear it. And all right, we got ourselves a bit of an interview with a wonderful and amazing Kungfufruitcup. He's going to be speaking with the runners of the BS Legend of Zelda race coming up, Iceblue and Benny Van.
Well, thank you so much, Iggy. That's so sweet. Hello, everyone. Hope you're enjoying today, Thursday, of Awesome Games Done Quick Online 2023. I know I am, of course. So nice to be back with you all. And I am joined today by Iceblue and Vonnie Von for their upcoming BS Legend of Zelda 100% race. How's it going, you two?
I'm doing great.
It's going good.
Yeah.
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 Good.
Yeah.
There we go. You know what? That's a great start. A good start to the day. A good way to get going. And I'm excited for, of course, I'm excited for more Zelda games. I'm always excited for more Zelda games. And I'm excited to talk about it. But okay, so I saw this on the schedule and I was like, BS Legend of Zelda? What? What is that? So, I mean, I don't know which one of you wants to take this question, but what does it stand for and why have we like never heard of this?
I'll start here because it's funny you say that you saw it on a schedule. My introduction to this game was for, there is a group called Retro Gaming Live TV. They do an event every year called Retrothon, and this is about 2 years ago. I saw it on the schedule and I wondered the same thing. So I started watching the run for about a minute and then I shut it off because I was like, I don't want to be spoiled on the rest. I want to casual this. I want to play this game through. It looks really cool. I eventually got around to doing it. And I was like, okay, let me speed run it. And then kind of the rest is history from there.
Awesome. Okay. But we don't know what this is. Tell us, like, you got to see it firsthand and then do it casually. But like, what are we going to be expecting?
Yeah.
What makes this different from other Zelda games? Why haven't we heard of it?
So it was only introduced in Japan. So there was like a little attachment for the Super Famicom, and it was called the Satella View. And it allowed you to connect to the internet and download like files. And you would download these files and you would play these, and they would release smaller files every week. This game in particular had 4 weeks worth of files, which would allow you to only do 2 dungeons a week. So they would kind of like hard lock you behind everything. And then like once you got to the 4th week, you could complete the game. And somebody was generous enough to archive all this and kind of piece it together.
Yeah. Like put it into one game. But it's like an episodic Zelda game.
It is, actually.
Somewhat, yes. Yeah, so the ROM that we're going to be using is going to be all 4 of those episodes stitched together in one contiguous ROM such that it can be played from beginning to end in one sitting. And in fact, there's going to be a particular room that we will enter in the run where 2 of the people that put it together, their names, you know, they kind of shout themselves out in there. So we'll be sure to mention that, because obviously we owe a deep amount of gratitude to those folks for making this game what it is and allowing us to play it the way that we do.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, yeah,
absolutely.
You should, okay, cool. Because when you said that at first, I'm like, are we going to see just the episodic part of this? I don't know. You know, I'm glad that it's all stitched together. So you get to see the whole thing. Again, that's why it's a 100% race. Now, so again, since this is so new for so many of us, what would you say are some of the biggest differences, maybe just in visuals or tech, between this and like the other, maybe the original Legend of Zelda?
Yeah, so this game is going to bear a lot of resemblances to the original Legend of Zelda. And as such, on the surface, a lot of people think that it's basically just like a remake, but I assure you it's not. There's plenty of differences. We'll talk a lot about the tech in there. There are some things, there's a little bit of overlap with the original one. I know a lot of people are familiar with that. So, but there are several differences from the original. That, I mean, it does set itself apart as its own game, certainly.
Yeah. Oh, that's fair.
It's its own standalone game. It's an official licensed Nintendo title. And this run in particular, and the Any% category, is it's completely glitchless. Not trying to hint or nudge at anybody here, but
anyone wants to go hunting?
We could use some glitches. Yeah, we could use some glitches in this game.
So what you're saying is you'd love for more people to check out the game so that maybe they can get involved and help.
Oh, yeah, precisely. Absolutely.
Yes.
Absolutely.
I wonder if like the people stitching it together had any impact on like the ability to insert glitches into it, or you know how that might affect tech over time. Not sure if you have any info on that, but just kind of amusing.
Really too much info, but yeah,
not the word Giga.
Saint Giga, the people who made it, they just kind of, they were the ones who designed the whole episodic version of it.
Right. That's fair. That's a good point. Okay, so, but before I let you all go to get ready for your race, mm-hmm. I just have to ask, I've heard a little something about like a side wager, side bet.
Yeah.
Side wager.
Yeah. It's more like a main wager. Yeah. So Iceblue and I have come to an agreement that whoever wins this race is going to designate a game that, so whoever wins the race is going to pick a game that they have speedrun that the other person has not. And that, and the loser of the race has to learn that game. So I have my game all picked out. I'm really excited to reveal it after after the race is over, so that y'all can see what it is. And
spewing with confidence, I like it. Spewing with confidence, I like it.
Oh my gosh, I heard that. Don't think I didn't hear that. All right, well, we have some confident runners here who are excited to show off their victory game that the other person's going to have to learn. That's awesome. So you all need to stick around, not only so you can see what this BS Legend of Zelda game is all about, but then also to see the winner's game choice for the other person. So best of luck to the both of you. Thank you so much for chatting with me today. It's been an absolute pleasure. And I'll see you all later on for the daily recap. Hope you have a wonderful rest of your time watching the marathon, everyone. Please make sure you're getting in your donations for the upcoming bonus game. Yay, Mario Kart and such. And we'll see you soon. All right, excited for the race. Yay.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
Thank you, Fu, Iceblue, and Vonnie Vaughn. Looking forward to that Legend of Zelda race, mainly because I'm hosting it, but it's going to be a good time regardless. We got ourselves $25 donation from JP Manon. They say, donating in honor of my late friend Corroded, who also loved GDQ. Let's reach that 1 million. Everybody, you're doing amazing on those incentives. We're a quarter of the way to Mario Kart 8. We're a third of the way into meeting Blindfold Demise Fight. We are literally making million-dollar moves. Everyone, keep it going. And hey, looks like we're ready to go for the next run. He is one with the Force, and the Force is with him. So everyone say, hello there, and give a buena suerte to Alnak and his any percent run of Jedi Knight, Mysteries of the Sith.